Hi students, for next three lessons, we'll be focusing quite a fair bit on geometry. So today we are starting on construction of triangles. So first and foremost, you need to have a geometrical set at home. I hope you have brought it home. So if not, I think you really have to find ways to make do. Another way is you can ask your parents to order online, whether through Officeworks or even Kmart, okay, to get a set for yourself. Okay, you really need it for the next few lessons. So to construct a triangle, a few things that you need. Of course, you need a pencil, a protractor, and a ruler. So on this particular page, 688, so you're supposed to construct a triangle based on the instructions given. One is an equilateral triangle, one is an isosceles triangle, and the other one is a scalene triangle. So I'm going to show the demonstration on how to draw an equilateral triangle and scalene triangles today. So they say, draw a line that is at least 95 mm. So I've drawn a 100 mm, which is equivalent to 10 cm line. Again, this is not drawn to scale, just be mindful. So I just draw a line that's 10 cm, okay? And then from here, they say at point B, I assume point B is here, which is different from this A and B here, okay? Assume that this is point B and mark 60 degrees, put a protractor there. Remember, this part must align with the line and this corner must be aligned to the end of the line. And then from here, you mark 60 degrees, which is here. I put a dot. And then after that, I remove the protractor and I draw a 10 cm line. Okay, this is fairly accurate, 10 cm. And once you have this second line, this point to this point here will naturally be 10 cm. Reason is, if this is 10, this is 10, and if this is 60 degrees, naturally these two angles must also be 60 degrees based on the equilateral triangles property. Okay, so give it a try on your own, okay, and I'm quite certain you will be able to draw a fairly accurate equilateral triangle using this instruction. And then after drawing this, you will need to answer all these questions given here. Okay, moving on to the next part. Of course the labeling, okay, is important. Moving on to the scalene triangle. Again, following the instruction, construct an angle 70 degrees at Y. So this is Y. I measure 70 degrees again, putting a protractor against it. Oh, 70 degrees is somewhere here. I put a dot. Okay, the dot is there. I remove the triangle. Then I extend the line from Y to the red dot as far as possible. Doesn't really matter. And then from here, I need to construct another angle at Z, okay, at 45 degrees angle. So where is 45 degrees? 45 degrees angle is somewhere around here. Put a dot there, that's right. Remove the protractor. And from Z, align with the dot, cut across. As you can see, this part here whereby the two lines touches each other, this point here, this point is actually X. Got it? And once after drawing this triangle, to answer the rest of the question accordingly. Okay, we're going to touch a little bit on 3D shapes, tetrahedrons, as well as a square pyramid. And two of them have some similarity, and towards the end of the lesson, you need to do some research to find out what are the similarities between the two 3D shapes. Okay, the first one given is a tetrahedron. You know, I've given you two examples here. So like this this peanut package and this milk packet, these are all tetrahedron shape. I'm sure you can still find some of them available in the supermarket. Okay, so looking at the first one, the juice box, okay. Seems like it's a tetrahedron. And it's quite unique because it's made out of four equilateral triangles. If you can look at the net, okay, you can actually see it very clearly, isn't it? It's four equilateral triangle. So this shape is called tetrahedrons. And how many vertices? Okay, let's revise again. What is vertices? Vertices are basically all the corner points on the shape itself. Okay, so how many corner points are there in this particular shape? Okay, do a count. Okay, next thing is the edges. What are edges? Edges are basically the lines that join the vertices together. So like this line, it actually joins this point with this point here, isn't it? So how many edges are there in the tetrahedron? Next is the faces. Faces basically talking about this one. Okay, that is the face. How many faces are there on a tetrahedron? Do a count again. And I've already given you the hint about the equilateral, right? So these are what? Equilateral triangles. That's right. Okay, moving on to a square base pyramid. So you're supposed to draw a net. So I actually drawn some for you, and they are more available. Okay, do not copy mine. If you want to use, you can use one of it, and then why don't you investigate and draw another different one? Okay, again from here, you're supposed to write down the name of this shape, how many vertices, edges, and the base. What's so special about the base of this this pyramid? And they say four of the faces are congruent. Okay, the meaning of congruent is meaning they are equal in size. Okay, they are equal in size. And last but not least, they say explain why these shapes belong to the same family of 3D shapes. So I will use this this word called apex. Do some research on this and find out why is there such a term apex being used to describe the tetrahedron as well as a square-based pyramid. And from there, using this word as your backbone to describe these two shapes. Okay. That's all for today's lesson. Thank you very much. You may want to contact me on Teams or direct message if you have any concern. Okay, bye-bye.